open flowers?
I don't know. Let's look a little closer.
There's a hole in there.
So what we've been doing is going outside of the school and Corcoran. We have been seeing like what kind of tree is it, how to tell what kind of tree it is. So that's really new for me because I just thought every tree was the same. But I guess we learned like from the bark and all the scratches and like the ends and the points and everything, it's really nice. So we're just keeping data on the trees and how they grow over time.
Me and my partner have like 4 trees that we've been looking at consistently.
There's fruits open. Yeah. There's no pollen on it.
Yeah. I realized that there's so much going on that like scientists can't do everything on their own. They can't observe every single little tree. And so I think it's kind of cool that I, as a student, can go out and like add to that scientific community. And it makes me feel like I have at least a little bit of an impact, you know?
Yeah. Are they totally open?
No.
Are you serious?
I don't know. Why?
Well, I see a lot I see some bees and flies flying around, so I guess they're open.
Yeah.
And do you see leaves?
Yep.
But the biggest thing is getting kids to see things that they have seen every day but have never seen before. Because when they start to see those things, they can't ever unsee them again. Because they're always now going to notice when things blossom, when the leaves burst. They're going to notice flowers on trees. They're going to see these things that most of us don't see. I didn't see for a long time, even though I grew up here and loved being out in the forest.
Are some of them?
Yeah, some of them are bad.
What do you think? Are some of these breaking leaf buds? Or are they all leaves out already?
Are all breaking.
Oh, aren't those colors great? Oh, they're so beautiful.
Whoa, let's see one of those. Let's
So phenology is the seasonal timing of biological activity of plants and animals. So here at Cedar Creek, the work that we're doing monitoring phenology is focused on really understanding how the plant communities here at Cedar Creek might be changing with our changing climate.
Submit.
Great.
Perfect.
All right, next plant.
So Chris Bajarski is a staff scientist in my lab at the University of Minnesota. And he monitors about 85 plants weekly here at Cedar Creek. And we're monitoring phenology of those 85 plants, and we have been doing so for 9 years at this point, so we're in our 9th year.
Okay, red maple 2.
We monitor phenology using methods and protocols developed by a program called Nature's Notebook, which is a citizen science program run by the USA National Phenology Network. And so the kind of data I need is really data on a lot of trees across a lot of area. And so for me, the citizen science piece is absolutely critical. That's where my data comes from. I cannot alone collect enough data to answer the questions I have about phenology and a changing climate. I get ideas from the citizen scientists, right? So they're also the boots on the ground. They're the ones that are seeing things. And while they send me my data, sometimes they'll say, you know, I noticed this and it was really weird. And so that becomes that I wonder. And those citizen scientists become the drivers of the science too.
Whoa, blue-beet lily's up. This wasn't even up on Wednesday.
So no to leaves, flowers or flower buds?
I don't see that.
No.
They'd be coming up from the middle on a stalk. You haven't seen this since October?
Yeah.
Welcome back, Bluebead Lily.
Mm-hmm.